What is up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Zayd Blade's Escapades. We're back after being away. What the crap is on my face? I don't even know. This is supposed to be the helmet. Torque? I have no idea. No idea what Torque is. Anyway, welcome back. And we've been doing some things since we got back to the house here. Wrong way. I'll just show you a little bit of what I have planned. Anything out here? No. Grind up some netherrack. Now, I don't know if you remember, but this hill came out to about, right about here. And I've actually chopped it open to make way for some room, because we have lots of good stuff that we have planting. Needing of planting, anyway. The carrots, which I can use once I get some more sheep. We got some hay here, used to make some sandwiches. Some yummy, yummy sandwiches. Let me get some... Let me just do some harvesting real quick here. Alright. So, yeah, we have that. We have a nice little road here that leads to our main area. And also leads to this little house here. Now, what I was thinking, since we got a brewing stand from the witch hut, and we also now have the ability to enchant things with the enchantment table, I thought that we'd make this tower here. It's not going to be a big tower. It's going to be a medium-sized tower, or a small tower, I guess, if you think how big they can actually be. And I'll have several floors. I might make a dungeon and have my stuff going on with brewing down the dungeon. Not sure. Not too sure what I'll do with this. But this is the first building that I'm actually going to build, because this wasn't really a building. That was kind of like a tunnel or a cave. That's not really a building. That's a cave. So I figure this will be the first official building we have here. The other thing I want to do, now that I have some enchanting stuff, I want to start enchanting my tools so I can get some better use out of them. I want to start clearing out these forests. I want to start smoothing out the terrain like I've done here. Obviously, I'm going to keep some of this relic stuff, tear the rest of this down and have the weird house here. I'll probably eventually start transforming this into a basement of a big house or a castle or something. Let's see what else. I want to put some farms, not just this kind of farm, like a real farmland, maybe over here, maybe prop it up a little bit, make it a little bit higher. And I also want to fence off my entire area, because it's getting a bit annoying having monsters and spiders coming in and messing around with me. So being able to clear this off, light it up, and then block it off will be good. Also, I mean, I've got some netherrack here going. Let me just turn this off. It is so annoying, but it's necessary. I really need to have the ability to, you know, grind up stuff, but it's just right here is just so freaking loud. And I can even hear it from my house. It used to be right here, actually. So it's just four more blocks closer, but that's four blocks closer to the house, so I can hear it. So it is a fair bit annoying. So I need to find something I can do with that, because it's just, like I said, annoying. I might build myself a multi-purpose house, so I can have this in my house for my brewing. Maybe have a temporary grinder in my house for doing some niggly grinding, and then have some automated builds where I just basically have this hilltop or whatever far away from where I normally propagate. And I just let the thing go full bore. You know, I put a hopper on top of it, maybe a couple hoppers, and just let it grind whatever's there into another hopper so that I have the ability... Oop, not that. So that I have the ability just to keep grinding things. Ooh, yay. Some more chocolate. Yeah, like I said, so I can keep grinding things and not have to worry about the sound. Oh, crap, I turned it off. Let's get that back on here. Now, why do I need ground netherrack? I need ground netherrack so I can make hellfire dust with this, and then hellfire dust with coal dust into... Well, that's nice. Let me go over here real quick. Hopefully nothing's over here. Hellfire dust and coal dust. Ooh, I'll risk it. I know that nothing's in that water there because it's too shallow to actually have anything in there. There we go. All good, all good. Alright. Yeah, with coal dust to make more torches, because that's the best way to make torches. If I make torches that way, I get the normal 4 for 1. So 1 coal actually equals 4 torches, which is what I need to aim for getting. Alright, let's grab that stuff there. Here's some more stuff for the birdies. Right, so what I'll do is I'm going to plan out this build that I have coming. And when it's day, we'll build it together and put some detail into it. And then, of course, we need to start blocking things off, like I said. Make some walls, not just fences and stuff like that. Oh, that's right, I'm burning iron nuggets down here from what I found on my journey. So I've got a couple more iron nuggets here. Yeah, so I want to fence that off too this episode. So that's the main episode, the main thing we're going to do this episode. We had a lot of traveling, which was, it was alright. I mean, obviously, we don't want to be traveling forever, and it can get a bit annoying. So it's good to be home. But I want to get some work done with getting this place cleared out a bit better. And better safety. I mean, just having this in front of a door, I don't even have to worry about having a slab in front of a door, you know? I want to just be able to open doors and close doors with nothing coming in here. And the only way that can happen is if I start building some defenses. Yeah. Anyway, I'll be back when it's morning time, and I'll see you guys then. Cheers. Alright, guys, let's build this thing. Oh, hold on, let me take care of this guy first. Come here, dude. Thank you for your balls. Though I haven't found any more diamonds, really, so not needing them right now. Alright, so let's build this thing. So I've got the first floor done. Some things I need to do is get some... Get some of these slats done. So that I could build one of those. And I think I'm just gonna put this in the doorway for now anyway. I've got my ladders going up, and I want the open area here to be quite big, you know, quite a big area. I don't want the first thing you walk in here is like, oh, this is small. So let's work on getting some more of these here. Some more of these cobblestone slabs. And let's just plop them there. This is pretty tall. Is that too tall? Should I put them there? Oh, I shouldn't be using... I should be using wood. Crap. Okay, this is going to be fun. Better Than Wolves has really crappy way of placing blocks. That's the one pet peeve that I have about this mod, is the way that you have to place their half slab blocks. They place just like regular blocks, not like normal half slabs, which means you can place them differently than your normal block. So you can place them, not there. You can place them along the wall like this. Oops. So, I mean, it looks nice, but the problem I have with that is you used to be able to take the block and hit it with your open hand. And when you hit it with your open hand, it actually allowed you to, what's it called? It allowed you to move the block so I could, if I didn't like the position it was in, it would just change its position. So if I didn't like it like this, I could just use my open hand and just go doop, 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 doop. But he took that away, and I don't know why he did that. I'm sure he had his reasons, but I'm just telling you, it is so annoying, because you want to place your block, and you place it wrong, and then it's just, you can't fix it quick. You've got to take it down, replace the block, and just like this, I've got to put blocks above the floor. So it's just double placing, which is really annoying, you know, to have to double place a block. Because really, what I mean by double placing is I have to come up here now and remove this whole level, because it's not needed. It was just there to help me build the floor. So I tend to use the normal half slabs if I'm going to do a floor, the normal Minecraft half slabs, because they just are much easier to work with when it comes to placing them for floors. So you don't have to place anything above them, like gravel, no, not gravel, like dirt or anything. So, anyway, there we go. I'm going to run in and get my... Oh, come on, go down. There we go. Get my table, my enchanting table, and place it. Now, I don't have any books, I don't believe, which is... There was, like, three places to get books, and I didn't grab one. I was just like, that's so stupid. I was just completely stupid. I really was. I should have grabbed the books while I was over there, and I completely forgot. And I think I also kind of thought, well, I could do that later, which is true. I do know how to get there, but it's a dangerous trip right now because it's, it's just a dangerous trip to do right now. There's no reason to put myself in that amount of danger. Now, the great thing about this, well, I guess I can't get a full one. The good thing about this kind of model is that I have enough room to place all of the bookshelves minus the corners and minus, well, this side here, but I don't think this side matters. I think the maximum is 3, 3, 3, but obviously you're going to miss those two, and those two, and those two. So it has its trade-offs. I might make this one wider. I could do that, make it one wider, but then I have this empty gap behind them with no reason of doing that besides having all the books. So we'll see. This is mainly temporary anyway until you get the better version, which is the... I can't remember the name of the block. I've never actually gotten it. It's the Infernal Enchanter, that's right. The Infernal Enchanter, which is going to be freaking awesome. So I thought I'd leave this open just because I thought enchanting's pretty cool in an open area. Or I might not. I don't know. I might think about it because most... enchanting. Oh, plus I have the bookshelf, so yeah, never mind, scratch that idea. I won't leave it open, but I might put windows here even though you can't see them, and I want this to look like an old study room, have that kind of feel. Yeah, so, and I might do another level, maybe two. I might actually put my, where do I put the lights? I'll put one there, two there. I might actually put, like, another portal above or below, but, I mean, it has to be 20 blocks away from any animal, for bad effects not to happen to them. I think it's 25. I don't know. I do 25, or more, just to be on the safe side. All right, so let's make ourselves a door, which is pretty easy with these blocks here. I think I need 6 of them. Yeah, there we go. Okay. And, oops. Shift. Should I have the door there? The thing is, if I had the door here, monsters will die in the sun. If I have the door on the inside, it gives it more depth, but at the same time, monsters will not die on the inside. The other thing I'll do is I'll place those there. Maybe that'll give it some depth. Looks pretty cool, actually. I mean, it needs some work. It's very plain. But it'll do for now for the kind of level tools we have. I can actually now start using my levels to enchant my tools, which means I'll probably want to redo my tools, remelt them down, make them sure they're full-fledged in case I get some good enchantments. And I actually might melt down all of my tools and make a couple of pickaxes for the main reason. Good pickaxes is really good. So if I melt down all of these and make 2 pickaxes, then I can do 2 enchants at a time. And if I don't like them, I can melt them and do them again. I mean, I have 26 levels, so I've got a fair few levels to mess with before you worry about that. So, all right, I'll throw these in, and I'll be right back when it's time to enchant them. All right, cheers. All right, guys, I'm back. It was a night or so, but I'm back, and it's time to go up to our nice little area here. Oh, crap. I forgot to make the other pickaxe. Actually, I say that, but yeah. I think I made it. Yeah, I made it, and then I had a zombie attack. I had to use it and to kill it, and I ended up using some of its life, and I'd rather not do that if I can get it to be enchanted first. So here we go. You can only do level 1 enchantments because we have no books. I think it goes up every 2, and the max you can get is like 5 levels. So what do we got? Efficiency 1, not bad. Efficiency 1. All right. Yeah, so... Well, that sucked. Let's try that again. I hate you. I'm not gonna look at you, but I dislike you a lot. All right, so let's I'm not sure if efficiency one's the best I can get with a level one, so I'll melt those to the other two things. We'll just keep it simple. Oh, I got that iron shovel from a zombie that I killed with that pickaxe. Well, the other pickaxe, anyway. Melt all this stuff back up. Melt you up, too. Might as well. Keep them nice and sharp. My shears sharp, or my scissors sharp. My skizzes. Alright. Oh, forgot to melt that one, too. Crap. There we go. Oh, crap. Just gotta melt all the iron stuff first. Okay. Alright, well, I'll be back when that's done. Cheers. Alright, you guys. So, did a little more building. Oh, crap. It's not day yet. As you can see, I made this a little bit wider, which is pretty cool. Zombie over there. I've really got to secure this place. It's not so dangerous as much as annoying, because they're not too hard to handle, to be honest. They're just skeletons and zombies and whatever. But don't want to get overrun with them either, or have one take me by surprise. Is it burning yet? Yeah, okay, they're burning now. But that's the other thing I got to realize is I've out this one, which means that I've got some skeletons just sitting right over here in the shade, which I can't let happen. So anyway, I'll show you what I got. I got a unbreaking diamond shovel, efficiency 1 pick, and efficiency 1 axe, which, I mean, what are you going to expect for level 1 with no bookshelves? Not much. Let's kill you. Dead. Where's he? Oh, he's standing at the trees. I got to take care of those trees. Oh, crap. I'm not going to even come near him because he's just too much trouble as he is. Yeah, here he is. Well, here it is. Not necessarily a he. Short little castle-like structure. Not bad, I don't think. It turned out all right. It could look better, but for now. For now, that'll do. And I think I'll need to put this stuff... Oh, they could still climb up here, couldn't they? I'll have to figure out what to do with that. There's got to be something I can do to keep the little guys from sitting here and... Oh, well. I guess the only thing I can do is just secure this a bit more. But there, that's pretty nice for now. Anyway, so I've got my tools now. I need to get more stone. This is all of the stone I have left. The other thing that I need to do now that I have the ability and the... Well, just the repairable tools... Diamond tools, and I can actually use my levels now. What I need to do is build a mob farm. I think it's, yeah, mob farm. And it's kind of hard to figure out where to do that, but I think the best place would be right here. Now, I'm not too sure if I want to build up or down. And by that, I mean, do I want to... whoops. Do I want to have a tower going way up into the sky, way up high, and then having this drop down? What that does, it gives me control over how it is, and I can make it as tall as I want so that it's just right for spawning. The other thing I could do is turn this off over here. Shouldn't have this on unless I need it on. Yeah, look at that iron. Beautiful. Beautiful. Anyway, like I was saying, the other nice thing about having it above ground is that you control how high it is. You control where it is. You can't control the water, so I wouldn't be able to build it here. I'd have to build it somewhere near here because there's a water source, and that allows me to automate the system a bit. Get rid of you. That allows me to automate the system because I can have them drop, being pushed with water to some location and be cut up by saws, which allows me to get more heads. What else does it allow me to do? Get more heads, and that's something else. Oh, increase drop chances, I think. Yeah, so I mean, I could do that there, or here, or somewhere, and have this big monstrosity sitting in the sky. Or I could do it the other way, and that is just build down. Now, I'm not in a mountain biome, so I assume right now I'm at level 64. Now, that means I can only build this thing 64 feet down, which limits me on my sorting system. I can only have so much space for sorting, which is a pain, doing it that way, but I've done it both ways, and the cool thing about building it up is I can go way high, fill myself up with food, just let these things just spawn and die, and come back and be like, holy crap, I've got tons of stuff, which is awesome. I mean, that's really cool. But the problem with that also is it's so high up, if I fall, I die. As I'm building this thing, I could fall and die. I mean, it's dangerous. Plus, I need tons and tons of cobblestone to build this thing. Whereas if I dig down, it could be hidden. You won't hear anything going on because it'll all be way down at, like, I don't know, Y15 or maybe even Y5. You know what I'm saying? Where all the mob processing is. It's a pain to go all the way down there to get it. If I built it up there, I'd only have to go down a level or two to get all the drops and XP and stuff. Whereas here, I'd have to go all the way down to the bottom and all the way back to the top. But like I said, the downfall is just having the, the cobblestone to build one so tall. So seeing how I'm building most things inside hills this time around, I think what I'll do is I'll build a huge underground mob trap. You have to start it up pretty high and then just build it straight down. So I think I'll start it here. And as I go down, if I find caves, I'll clear them out. But I'm trying to think of a good size area. Well, I should probably have it right here in the middle, to be honest. Just straight down from here a couple feet, maybe a couple levels, 3 or 4. And then start digging it out. Then I'll have to figure out how big I want it. And we'll do that next episode. We'll go through the whole process of me mapping it out with dirt, and then digging down to the level, and then start digging it out. It's a pretty time-consuming process. The other thing I need to do and get ready is I need vines. I have not gone vine collecting yet. I know that there's vines over here in the whatever this thing's called. Hold on, let me just put you down. There are vines in the swamp area, and so I can collect some vines from there. I don't have to go all the way to the jungle like I thought I did, which is good. One less thing I have to worry about, or one less, you know, way I have to go. But I need a whole lot of vine, and it's not efficient to just go around and cut them off the trees like this, you know what I mean? And it's dangerous. I'm hearing something. Oh yeah, see, it's dangerous to do this. To go out here and just start chopping. Not to mention it takes time and is a little bit annoying. So the other way to do it, oh, there's two different biomes going on here. The other way to do it is to automate it by putting it above a saw and having it be collected in a, what's that called? In a hopper. Yeah, my brain's not working properly. So we could collect it in a hopper, which will automate the process. Now, of course, we should have a whole bunch of these saws cutting these things at a time, and we really want to fill this out because we want to have as much as possible being cut at any given time. And so what happens is when this grows down over top of the saw then cuts it. Man, I'm just hearing these whatever they are everywhere. Oh, it's gone. Oh well. It automatically cuts these vines as it grows, which is... Wow, that's weird. Some weird things going on. Which is what I need. I need it to cut it when it grows, automatically. So I'll have to build a couple of them to do that. And the reason why is because you build vine traps, and I'll show you what they are in just a second. Too bad I can't turn oak leaves to vines. Just place you and break you. There you go. Stay away from the cows. Okay. And feed the chickens. I have so many sandwiches, it's awesome. This is exactly what I was saying. Look at this. I've got all these sandwiches. I have even more wheat. I have tons and tons of that. Ham and eggs, which is good. Tons of eggs. But those sandwiches, they just double your food. It's just crazy how good they actually are. Food production. Anyway, sorry, aside from that, let me just eat a little bit and I'll show you what these vine traps look like. So, a vine trap is just a... It's not even a full block. You place it down, it looks like this. Now, the cool thing is you can walk right through it. It is not a real block. But the mobs see it as a real block. Now, mobs can't spawn on top of it, but they'll spawn and walk where it is because they see this as a real block, as a full block, or at least something they could step on. But it's not. Now, you can place them on the top like that, or you can place them on the bottom. Either way, it doesn't matter. They see it as a block, they step on it, they fall through, and hopefully to their death. Now what I'll do is I'm going to make this really cool design that I've seen this guy do before. Can't remember his name, but if I remember it, I'll put it in the comments. And it's basically this underground cavern, and you have four lanes, and they all lead to this 4x4 hole. The zombies and skeletons and whatever else spawns gets pushed down into the water, and then get pushed into saws, and those saws kill them, and then their goods just drop down into a sorting system, which I'll show you. It's quite complex, and there's also a whole bunch of physics and things involved in this sorting system. It's crazy. It's cool, too, because you can sort it out in so many different levels, because there's buoyancy, there's heaviness, which is sort of like buoyancy. There's also different sizes, and we have ladders and slats and grates and different things which we can allow items to pass through, and certain ones will pass through ones while others won't pass through. And then you can collect different things in different parts, and then you can automate it by allowing all of the armor to go to a heated furnace or whatever that thing is in there, crucible, and melt right away. And then you just get your stuff in there, and you can have your arrows go to once. You're always making flint, so you can make arrows and all sorts of things. It's really cool. Sorting system. But we'll get into that next episode. That might be several episodes, because it's going to take us a good amount of time to dig that out. The cool thing is, we'll find caves that will light up with our torches that we'll make. Which might as well do that right now. And we'll also be able to light up those caves so that we don't have the issue with spawning. Now, the one bad thing, oh, it's a dark night, about these underground ones is that it really does matter about caves. Whoa, what the crap? I'm hearing... How did you spawn down there? How'd you spawn down here? Oh, shoot. Are you kidding me? I've already got my own little mob spawner down there. Crap. That's not good. Alright, I thought... Oh, okay, it is a bit dark. Dang. Okay, well... That's solved. I forgot to go back down there and light it up. What an idiot. He must have just wandered up by accident. This is crazy. Good thing I had that door there. Was I'd be zombie food. Oh, it's dark out there. So, yeah. And just saying that right now, just the fact of the zombie spawn rates being so low by digging it down in the ground, I think that we're just going to dig up. And what I'll have next episode is just a complete mining episode. I'm going to mine so much cobblestone, it's going to be crazy. That's what I'm going to have to do. Just mine up a whole bunch of cobblestone. And then once I've done that, you know, we'll be able to build the one of the sky. I'm just thinking, the sky one has so many benefits. I know you could die, and I know it's a bit more work, and you have to collect more cobblestone, but just the fact that I can build 25 levels high and make sure that there's absolutely no spawning around me, and just have pure spawns from the mob trap, falling into the mob trap and dying just like that. It's too good to build it underground. I don't know. I'll decide, and then next episode we'll do that. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. And make sure you leave a like if you liked. Subscribe if you really liked it and you want to see more of my content. And it also encourages me to make more videos. As you know, I take breaks every once in a while because it gets a lot. I've got a lot on my plate at times, and it's hard to always record, to get recording in. So Yeah, so just make sure you hit that like button and subscribe if you want to. And anyway, I'll see you guys later. Cheers.